Well, I thought she showed such tremendous class over these clickbait monsters, because even when, as you could see, she was clearly distressed, very thin and drawn, and dealing with a devastating health scare, she said this. Have a listen.
At this time, I'm also thinking of all those whose lives have been affected by cancer. For everyone facing this disease, in whatever form, please do not lose faith or hope. You are not alone.
I think Kate has bought herself immunity from criticism for years and years to come after this. But suddenly, Esther, the royal ranks look really thin. You know, you've got the king having cancer, you've got her having cancer, you've got the king apparent, you know, the heir apparent, William obviously distracted. Does that bring Prince Harry, only fifth in line to the throne, back into the picture?
I believe I speak on behalf of everyone in Britain when I say God forbid. I believe clearly the priority right now for the Prince of Wales and for Queen Camilla is obviously the King and Princess Catherine, and making sure that they recover as quickly as possible. Obviously, you do have other royals that could step in to help. Prince Andrew and the Sussexes are clearly not in that. To be included there, and also it would make sense that they would keep their distance from the Sussexes, because clearly there's a lot of sensitive medical information that will be shared between them as a family. The last thing they need is for Harry and his Netflix cameras to be floating around. These are not a couple that are known for their privacy.
Taking notes. So true. Esther Crackley, thank you so much indeed for your time. Really appreciate it.